This video is brought to you by MyWayTeaching.com.
Next is decrease in enthalpy a criteria for spontaneity? Okay, that is the question. So I will explain you in detail about this topic. Is decrease in enthalpy a criterion for spontaneity? Okay, so if we examine the phenomenon like flow of water downhill or fall of a stone on the ground, okay, we find that there is a net decrease in potential energy in the direction of change. What happens? Net decrease in potential energy. Okay, by analogy, we may be tempted to state that a chemical reaction is spontaneous in a given direction. Chemical reaction is spontaneous. Chemical reaction is spontaneous in a given direction. Okay, because decrease in energy has taken place as in the case of exothermic reactions. Decrease in energy has taken place as in the exothermic reaction. As in the exothermic reaction. So consider example. For example, three by two is equal to 46.1 kilojoule per mole of into -92.32 kilojoule per mole. Okay, plus of -285.8 kilojoule per mole. So the decrease in enthalpy is passing from reactants to products may be shown for exothermic reaction on enthalpy. Okay, I will show the diagram. This is enthalpy diagram for exothermic reactions and this is enthalpy diagram for endothermic reaction. Okay, what happens in this? Decrease in enthalpy in passing from reactants to products. So this is reactants to this is products. Okay, may be shown for exothermic reaction. Now therefore it becomes obvious that while decrease in enthalpy may be contributory factor for spontaneity, but it is not true for all the cases. So this is an enthalpy diagram for endothermic reaction. Okay, next concept is entropy and spontaneity. Okay, let us consider diffusion of two gases into each other in a closed container. See, this is the two gases in the closed container. Diffusion of two gases is isolated from the surrounding as shown in this figure. The two gases, say gas A and gas B, are respected by black dots. So this is gas A, this is gas B, respected by black dots and white dots respectively. So, and separated by a movable partition. So this is separated by this one. So when the partition is withdrawn, the gases begin to diffuse into each other, and after a period of time, diffusion will be complete. Let us examine the process before partition. What happens if we were to pick up the gas molecules from left container? We would be sure that this will be molecules also, as shown in this figure. If it is from the left container, we can say that this is a gas molecules A, and like that, if we are picking from right, that is gas B, we would be sure that this will be molecules of gas B. But if we were to pick up the molecules from container when partition is removed, so what happens after that? This is the figure when the partition is removed. We are not sure whether the molecules picked are of gas A or gas B. We say that the system has become less predictable or more chaotic. We may now formulate another postulate. In an isolated system, there is always a tendency for the system's energy to become more disordered, and this could be a criterion for spontaneous change. Okay, so this is the diffusion of two gases we considered. Now let us try to quantify entropy. One way to calculate the degree of disorder or chaotic distribution of energy among molecules, okay, would be through statistical method, which is beyond the scope of this treatment. Other way would be to relate this process to the heat involved in a process, which would make entropy a thermodynamic concept. Entropy, like any other thermodynamic property such as internal energy U and enthalpy H, is a state function, and delta S is independent of path. So entropy is like an, now you consider the entropy is like an any other thermodynamic property, like any other thermodynamic property such as internal energy U and enthalpy H is a state function, and delta S is independent of path. Delta S is independent of path. Okay, now whenever heat is added to the system, it increases molecular motions, causing increased randomness in the system. Thus, heat Q has randomizing influence on the system. Can we then equate delta S with Q? Wait, experience suggests that though distribution of heat also depends on the temperature at which heat is added to the system. A system at higher temperature has greater randomness in it than one at lower temperature. So we know that the system at higher temperature, okay, has a greater randomness, has a greater randomness in it rather than one at lower temperature. Thus, temperature is the measure of average chaotic motion of particles in the system. So next, heat added to a system at lower temperature causes greater randomness than when the same quantity of heat is added to at higher temperature. This suggests that the entropy changes, we can say that the entropy changes inversely proportional to the temperature. Delta S is related with Q. And T for a reversible reaction. As delta S is Q, that is reversible, divided by T. Okay, the total entropy, delta S total, we can call that is total entropy for the system and surroundings of a spontaneous process, that is given by delta S system plus delta S surrounding this one. Okay. Next, when a system is in equilibrium, the entropy is maximum. Change in entropy, delta S is equal to zero. When the system is in equilibrium, delta S is equal to zero. We can say that entropy for a spontaneous process increases till it reaches maximum and at equilibrium, the change in entropy is zero. So since entropy is a state property, we can calculate the change in entropy of a reversible process. So we can say that delta S system, Q system, comma reversible divided by T. To find that both for reversible and irreversible expansion for an ideal gas under isothermal condition, for both reversible and irreversible expansion for an ideal gas under thermal conditions, delta U is equal to zero, but delta S total, that is delta S system plus delta S surrounding, is not zero for irreversible process. Thus, delta U does not discriminate between reversible and irreversible process, whereas delta S does. Okay, so this is about the is decrease in enthalpy a criterion for spontaneity is over, and the next one is this is about entropy and spontaneity. Okay.